Good morning. Let's talk about an important topic for today, radial nerve. Radial nerve is the most commonly damaged nerve in human body. Radial nerve is a nerve which has the best prognosis amongst all the nerves. Radial nerve is a nerve which is principally a motor nerve. Now let's understand what are the types of questions which are asked on radial nerve. So radial nerve. When you have a radial nerve palsy, it can be principally divided into two parts, high or low. In high radial nerve palsy, you have wrist drop, you have finger drop, and you have a sensory loss. Where specifically in dorsum of first web space, this area is supplied by radial nerve exclusively, median nerve exclusively, ulnar nerve exclusively. These are called as autonomous zones. So with radial nerve, high radial nerve palsy, you have wrist drop, finger drop, sensory loss. 1, 2, 3 plus. You have palsy of this muscle called as brachioradialis. Brachioradialis is the muscle which is here. If this muscle is paralyzed, it's a high radial nerve palsy. In low radial nerve palsy, you have wrist drop, finger drop, and sensory loss. Brachioradialis is not paralyzed. Then, radial nerve divides into two parts, posterior intraosseous nerve and superficial radial nerve. This is principally the sensory branch supplying this area. This is a motor nerve. Posterior intraosseous nerve pierces a muscle called as supinator, and its palsy causes finger drop, no sensory loss, no wrist drop. Now, if you have radial nerve palsy, you decide whether brachioradialis is involved or not, and you call it as high and low. If there is only finger drop, it's a posterior intraosseous nerve palsy. The question which was asked in JIPMER was a very, very intelligent MCQ. A patient has finger drop wrist drop, but no sensory loss. Which area is the nerve damaged? So the question had wrist drop, finger drop, but no sensory loss. Which area the nerve is damaged? The options were at the shoulder. That is not possible, because at the shoulder you have the axillary nerve which does not cause these symptoms. Second option, medial epicondyle of humerus. That's also not there because ulnar nerve is involved in that. That presents with claw hand. Third option, spiral groove. Fourth option, around the radial head. Spiral groove means the radial nerve. Around the radial head means posterior intraosseous nerve. Now you had to choose between these two. When you have a radial nerve palsy, you will have a wrist drop, you will have a finger drop, but there is a sensory loss. When you have a posterior tortuous nerve palsy, you don't have a wrist drop. Which one to choose? This or this? Now what do we understand from this? We understand from this that we have to choose either posterior tortuous nerve or radial nerve in the spinal cord. It is known that when a major trunk of a nerve is involved, it might have a partial loss. For example, in hip dislocation, most common level where a nerve is damaged is sciatic nerve, but it often presents like common peroneal nerve palsy. Why? Because common peroneal nerve is more sensitive to pressure and it is located peripherally into the sciatic nerve. So there is hip dislocation, damaging sciatic nerve, presentation of a CPN palsy, common peroneal nerve palsy, foot drop. Similarly, if you have a radial nerve palsy, it will cause wrist drop, will cause finger drop, might not have a sensory involvement as a partial presentation. But in posterior tortuous nerve palsy, in no scenario, we can have a wrist drop. So in JIPMER MCQ, the answer that we have to opt for is the radial nerve, because this explains the symptoms better. Coming again to the radial nerve question which came in May AIMS. If you have a fracture of humerus, if this is upper one third, the middle one third and lower one third, upper, middle, lower, at which level will the radial nerve be paralyzed? Now this is how the radial nerve travels. Into the groove in the middle one third, comes from the posterior compartment, pierces the lateral intermuscular septum and comes on the lateral side. If this is the glenoid, the head, the medial epicondyle, the lateral epicondyle, that is how it travels. It divides into two parts here, the superficial radial nerve, the posterior tortuous nerve, that's the head of radius. Around that, the posterior tortuous nerve takes a turn. Now, the question which is asked is, at which level the radial nerve is paralyzed? The upper one third, middle one third, lower one third. Most of the students answer this, so it's wrong, because most of the students answer this. The answer is lower one third. Why lower one third? Because it is fixed here, fixed. It pierces the intermuscular septum, and when there is a fracture involving this area, this goes and damages this nerve. And the image which was shown in May AIMS was, they had shown a fractured humerus lower one third and they had asked which nerve is damaged, and the answer was simple. The radial nerve which is fixed here in the intermuscular septum is damaged. And this presentation is called as the Holsten-Lewis sign. So this is AIMS May 2016. And this is JIPMER May 2016. Thank you very much. All the best. Radial nerve in today's world is the most important nerve, and continuing with it, when you have a wrist drop, the splint which is applied for it is the cock-up splint. This is number one asked MCQ in splints in today's world. Thank you very much.